The closing of the Seoul Olympics draws near. The men's marathon is the last event. Temperature 24 degrees centigrade, relative humidity 36%, wind northeasterly 1.5 meters per second. It is a sultry day for such a race. The runners set a slow pace because of the hot weather. Hussein Ahmed Saleh of Djibouti, Douglas Wakiuri of Kenya, and Takeyuki Nakayama of Japan are expected to battle for the gold. At the 20-kilometer point, about 20 runners, including Juma Ikanga of Tanzania, Wakihuri, Saleh, Nakayama, and Toshihiko Seko of Japan, Charles Spedding of Britain, and Gelindo Bordin of Italy form the leading group. The 42.195-kilometer course extends along the scenic Han River in Seoul. The race is a struggle for survival. The number of runners is gradually reduced. The gaps separating them grow wider as the race progresses. Point, Saleh increases the pace, but Bordin overtakes him at the 40.6-kilometer point. Like a burning candle which emits its strongest light before it dies out, Bordin has saved his final pitch for this last stage. Twenty-nine years old, height 180 centimeters, weight 68 kilograms, Gelindo Bordin. With a time of 2 hours 10 minutes 32 seconds, Bourdin gets the gold medal, Italy's first ever in Olympic marathon. Second is Douglas Wakihuri of Kenya. Third, Hussein Ahmed Saleh of Djibouti. And fourth, Takeyuki Nakayama of Japan. A marathon runner faces an awesome challenge of endurance. A gold medal in the marathon is the mark of a great hero.